Zombie Girl, we find a ZVZ. We saw a couple of very interesting versions of these earlier today in Take TV's Against the Odds tournament, but I think this one should be uniquely ours, especially with the players playing in this. Spawning here in the bottom, central portion of merry-go-round, in the wildcard group, invited back to represent the North American scene. It's, of course, the Red Zerg player, Gosu User.
Nipper writes as the blue Zerg, Samsung Galaxy Solar.
Solar, of course, playing bright and early instead of super late. Most of the tournaments we host, guys, we start them around 5 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and that's actually 9 p.m. in Korea. This is going to be the other end of the spectrum. I think it's about 9 a.m. in Korea. So,
yes.
Solar, hopefully, not going to miss school today for this or anything. I've been teasing him a little bit because his grades apparently not doing so great right now. But ZVZ and StarCraft II are definitely his forte. Who needs school? You're a DreamHack champion.
You know, I'm happy when Amy Korean is still in school, because that's like the only thing I'm learning in Korean class is how to talk to people about school. So I can finally be like, hey, Solar, study hard. And he'll be like, so impressed with Korean, right? No, I won't. Just kidding. Damn it. But seriously, otherwise I have nothing to talk about.
Well, I think... Well, hang on. Talk about this. One base guess in the pool time in Command of Ghost User. Again, like I kind of expect him to go a little bit aggressive in this set because it's Solar. You really don't want to tango in the macro game against someone that is a Korean player, that someone plays in Pro League, and someone who wins a DreamHack, right? Like, this has got to be the biggest underdog match there is. Because Ghost User's also been out of the scene for a while. Like, who the hell's this guy, right? You know? Used to be pretty good in Europe when he was playing for Millennium through the various team leagues, then kind of started casting, disappeared for a while, but started playing again recently. And I'm not sure if this was in preparation of the region lock WCS or if it was just his time, but I can certainly understand wanting to cheese out a little bit in this first game, because it is Solar you're coming up against. And let's be honest, who cares about honor? It's about winning the series.
I don't think Ghost User's cheesing.
Really? You don't think
so? I mean, it was a 15-15, wasn't it?
Well, he pulls off gas and goes for the all-in. Okay, change my definition.
Well, anyways, it is Lings at an earlier time than Solar, so they might get something. They might get something
smart,
done.
Like, if Solar, he might actually dodge the Overlord entirely.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, like if Solar doesn't make 2 to 4 Lings, like you normally just to get a scout, if he plays a little bit greedy, you can technically kill the queen if they're really not paying attention, but Solar actually gets 6 of Lings zone, so that shouldn't happen. I actually wanted to ask, do you think this is going to be like Damaga versus a...
I don't know that it'll be one-sided like that. I've actually seen some sick Ghost Users ZVZ back when he was in his prime. But again, he's been gone for a while. So I don't know if he was practicing on a barcode this whole time, right? Like the secret hermit Gosu. Or if this is just like, I don't know, one-sided. Well, I think we're going to feel in this first game for sure.
That Ling fight was one-sided, am I right?
Yeah. This one guy. Run! This really sucks too, because Solar starts his speed before Gosu User. I really thought Ghost User was going to go for it first, but instead invest in that Bailey Nest.
Yeah, he doesn't even get enough to have speed. That seems like a mistake. Why do you have 50 gas at this point? Like, what's, why not have only 50 gas and go down to zero? But then, anyways, he fixes it now. I think he's going to get speed, but now it's going to be obviously a lot later.
Someone dug up like an old Idra quote from like Brood War about making carriers, I guess. I never seen this.
Yeah, good. No, you've never seen it?
A very useful talent to have, or toy.
Yeah,
have.
That's, oh my god. So like every single time that I said stuff like it's a very useful talent to have, or like it's a good skill to have, you're just like,
I thought you were just adding like, I don't know, weird commentary.
Oh my god.
Just filled dead space.
Oh, Rifkin, I forget how much of a baby you are sometimes.
Stupid casual Rifkin, never watched Brood War.
StarCraft
2, Babby. Yeah, sorry guys, I'm a filthy casual. I wasn't really into the Brood War scene back in the day.
It wasn't Brood War, it was like StarCraft 2.
What?
Oh no, it was Brood War, actually. You're right.
What are you? You're the Babby now, Jesus.
There's so many intro quotes, I'm sorry. I was actually thinking of actually the one versus Cruncher. For some reason, I was getting Ghost User and Cruncher confused or whatever, because like, I thought that's why they brought up Idra in the first place. But anyways, we had a little bit of aggression here from Solar, but with Ghost User's own Baitlings, it's not really going to be a big deal.
Snipes off another Ling. Lair starts up here for pretty quick for Solar. Now, there was actually a situation again, guys, like we saw. Well, actually, hang on. Hold the thought. Banelings are going to waddle in here. Man, I miss the Baneling colors. Ryan, I actually asked him very specifically if he can go fix this. So they won't have it for WCS, but we'll have it. Yeah. But yeah, the bailing light bulbs are gonna be gone until this weekend, and then he told me he'd dedicate some time to it, so good guy Gamehart designing.
Look at this control. The ghost is just trying so hard to get lings or banelings across the map.
Yeah, really well handled there out of solar. Meanwhile, oh, runs into that baneling, kinda nasty. He gets a hit off, I guess, but not going so well for Ghost User, but he's not behind on tech, and he's not behind on drones. And that's often what happens sort of at this stage of the game. You're like, oh, oops, I overdroned, and now I have no roaches, and you've absolutely destroyed me because I have 5 and you have 14. He's actually keeping up the roach count here. I like the protection. I like the start to this. Baneling and Zergling shenanigans start of the game? Okay, that kind of failed. But they'll play the roach game out, and I don't know. Like, Sora's got a small lead right now, and a couple lings will help pepper this army, but again, Defender's Advantage is going to be a really big deal.
Question comes back down to who gets the third first, and that is Solar. No one has any more lings on the field to really stop this one way or the other. So Ghost User should throw down his own. And with Nevo Chamber, he's not going to go for the Baneling all that we've been seeing from, or the Roach Baneling all we've been seeing from Vortex.
Vortex's Roach Baneling was really early. That's something that usually comes, of course, like closer to the late game. You've maxed out. You're looking to find a way to punch a hole through your opponent. But yeah, his third's coming down really late. And the thing is, he scouted this too the whole time, right? Like, he knows it's there. This could hurt.
Yeah. No, Ling. Well, that Ling did its job and more so. Good job, Ling buddy. Well, Solar, now everything, it started off really great, as you were pointing out, like similar drone lead or similar roach counts, but now that third is so far ahead, his upgrades are going to be farther ahead as well. I wonder if he's going to throw out a second Evo Chamber. Maybe.
Well, Solar's roach count actually jettisoned at some point here.
Good word, man. Reading Thesaurus at night?
Yeah, I got that word of the day calendar going for me, you know? No, but seriously, like, Defender's Advantage is one thing, but being down 10 roaches is still being down 10 roaches. And even with Queens here, normally you see Lings cancel this base.
No!
Solar's gonna just kill this. Yeah.
Oh, those poor roaches look so slow. Oh,
he's just gonna try his best to fight it, but the Queens are wasting shots here on the Overseer, and realistically, he just needs to pull back, and I kind of feel like Solar's got his first game in the bag.
He needs to pull back and die. That's what's gonna happen right now.
Yeah, what's that phrase, like, tuck your legs or head between your legs in case you ask goodbye? Is that it?